Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon. I'm at this Lunatari. We're heading back for the boat. I'm gonna try to get to Newlake this episode. Now all these islands are open to us, but I'm sure some are tougher than others. I'm not sure how hard it's gonna be for us to find this boat. Feeling down south more, and I'm going to water. We're not good at swimming yet. No. Alright. And now it's getting dark out. I mean, if we just follow this shore around, we should find it. Knowing me, as soon as we lose sight of the shore, that'll be where the boat is. Okay, now I can't see crap. New scroll. So I thought I had it all the way down south. I mean, it wouldn't depart and go somewhere else, would it? There we go. Completely wrong. Now I parked the thing. Excuse me, guys. Okay. So we should be, I guess, here, and we want to go here. So first, I'm going to go around and go north, and then around that island. Should really just go directly north then. Okay. Here's our home island here. Here's our horsey. There's our raft that we don't need anymore. Run around the mountain range here. I think we run all the way around, but let me try to go. West from here. There is a little channel that runs through. I don't know if that's it. Brother, I don't think we're headed the right way. Okay, what is this? Hold on. I'm trying to get my cursor back out of the Give my cursor back. Okay. We're not going to be able to see Newlake from the shore. But this... this is it. This must be it. That little dip that our boat is at now, I think is this little dip here. So Newlake is there. So somehow I went up too far and I overshot. I must have been heading from here, actually, when I thought I was heading from here. I don't know how I did that, but... alright. So I'm just gonna go west a little bit more. Just now we're losing daylight. Did I go too far? I think so. I think I went too far. It's getting dark. Let's try to camp. I hope I'm just on the right, not continent, but... I don't know what might be out here. We need to come. I think we're at the Schwarzberg Mountains then? I think I overshot. Oh, I don't know if this is the right... swamp stuff here. I don't know if I'm at the right place. I'm lost! Let's keep going. Try to find something. I think where I thought I was is not where I thought I was. I can't get around this stuff here, can I? I really don't know where I am. Camping, I can see again. No scrolls. I think this might still be... there's a lot of mountains, I think. Just wondering where we are. I think maybe we're here. Maybe I missed this and need to go north. Maybe this little dip is that dip. I pointed that out to you guys. Maybe that's it. I'm gonna head with the assumption that we need to go north. I'm gonna assume we're here for now and try to go. Where even are we? Okay. I'm gonna go back around all this to get back to the boat. And that time's gonna go dark again. Then we'll have to camp again. Gonna go from there. Don't step in the water, stop taking damage. I mean, it makes sense, right? I'm comparing on the map. We've got this. Alright, I don't even care. Let's go on the boat. I'm heading north and see if we reach. Wish we could see more of the surrounding area at once. We can go up there. All right, let's rest. We have different elevations here, but we can just walk around them freely. This is a foresty type area, which is good because Newlake is. Ah! Doesn't that look like the old. I think we've made it. And there's a. A road. I can't. Look at that. Okay. The town of Newlake, guys, we made it. Okay, so I did end up on that. Our little voyage. I ended up heading probably from here and then head straight north, and I hit this, right, or somewhere along here. We were on this Thunderwust or whatever. Oh, there is a town here. So we ended up too far south, but then we went north and found it. I love the song. Yay. I love it when a plan comes together. You know, we didn't have a plan. We And it's still morning, so some of these places might be open. The iron sign shows an anvil, and below it the words Anton Hufnagel, Blacksmith. Master Workshop, open from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. There's probably another guy who repairs things. I wonder if his price would be about the same as this. It's somewhere around there. I'm not sure which is lower. I'm just not sure because if the disc is the same, I mean, what do they call it? Blue disc? Floating disc? Oh, it's a crystal ball. We repaired the disc, actually. Yeah. We might find some other things we might want to buy. But I'm definitely going to repair that soon. What did it say this place was? Inn of the Goddess? Well, that's not reception for an inn. That's a blacksmith, so that's an issue. That's an error. Bug, whatever. And there's something else over here. I thought I saw a sign. There's windows, but I doubt these can be interacted with or anything. I hope there's more to it than just these three places. I'm assuming this might be just an outer courtyard and those doors over there lead to the rest of the city? Or town, whatever? On the wooden sign it says, Inn of the Crater. Is that it? Just an inn? What was the sign? The same? Rooms to let, 20 pieces of gold per person. Inn of the Crater, okay. Okay, yeah, rooms to let. I'm not going to sleep just yet. When we do, we might wake up here. Just in case these might hold anything. Probably not. Shows here. Okay. And here be people. The old man looks at you quizzically and then says, "You have certainly already heard of the enormous whirlpool to the west of the Fort of Godsbane? Before the great floods, you could get through it into an underground cave, but no one should try that today, because the cave entrances were blocked by the catastrophe, and anyone who dares to enter the whirlpool will surely be torn to pieces." I'm writing this down. I have a little notepad, which has been put away for a while, because we haven't got a new quest for a while. So I'm assuming this is a place that we will eventually be able to go to anyway. Okay. Now just a pen. Okay. So whirlpool west of Fort Godsbane. You might remember that name from Amberstar. That's where the final dungeon at the end of the game took place. Before the Great Floods, you can get through. Cave entrance is blocked. Maybe with one of our tools we could actually clear the blockage. Maybe. Well, thanks for the info. And I wonder if this guy has a description as well. The town guard says, "I once went to the Temple Island of the Brotherhood to collect something for the Baron. The monks of the Brotherhood were already waiting for me in front of the entrance and gave me the package for the Baron. As I was leaving, I glanced into the entrance hall. I almost died of shock because a huge demon was crouching down in the center of the hall. I can tell you, people, not even 10 horses could ever drag me back to that damned island." Temple Island of the Brotherhood. I don't know which one that is. Temple. I wonder if that's the place here? Okay, there are monks there. And, for all we know, it's a, like a statue. Talk to people. The landlord smiles at you in friendship and says, "Welcome to my inn. Instead of sleeping on a bench in the town park, I would recommend taking a room here with me. The entrance to the crypt is in the town park, and I have heard that some of the undead have recently got out of the crypt." Huh. Alright, so the crypt, we must check that out. Anyone or anything else here? So how do we get to this town park then? Oh, you know what? I can't just go before I check these barrels. So I'm stealing from barrels right in front of this guard. Nothing. I just check it. Nope, I don't want to go there. Nope, nope, nope. Yeah, that's it. That's it for this place. The Inn of the Creator, and then... So maybe it just does go... It looked like they were just... Oh, there are... I just assumed that this was a wall here, and this was that... Oh, there was the same. Ah, good. Hello? Who might you be? The young woman stands still and says, "Have you heard? The Baron has had the crypt of Newlake sealed. It is rumored that some undead got out of the crypt, but the town guards apparently destroyed them before they could cause any trouble. As I heard, the Baron personally keeps the key to the crypt. Alright. So we want, the key. I mean, I would probably remember this, but... as key to crypt. Definitely want to be checking out that crypt. Well, thank you for that. What's this place? On the marble sign, you can read Main Library of Newlake. Alright, well, I don't think I stumbled into this crypt because the guy has holding a key. Hello? I don't know about this place. It's pretty creepy for a library. The old man holds a finger to his mouth. Shh. Kidoki. I'm just gonna look around then. There's a door there to my left. A door there as well. And books of some such up here, maybe? On closer inspection of the shelf, it becomes clear that the books there are false. They conceal a door. Oh. Well, I wanted some actual books. I'm gonna go here last. Because it seems like someplace you'd go last. Let me just go through these. Through these? Are these doors? Okay. I don't know why the dungeon, library is like a dungeon. I wonder if you can actually get any books. Huh. Amid the many books, one especially interests you, but you cannot say why. We also find a key to the shrine. Wingate book and book of herbs. I think they both interest me. Thank you very much. Anything else? Like no gold or anything? Alright. So, let's check it out. Book of herbs. Now, I think if we look at it, we just get that. So we want to use it. There are many effective herbs on Lyramion. These are the three most important ones. The Swamp Lily. This only grows in a small swamp to the northeast of the Tower of the Alchemists. In the past, it has proven helpful against every known type of poison. So we did find one for a quest to save the fisherman's daughter from swamp fever. Sorry about that. The Calmier Herb. This herb grows on an island in the artificial lake to the south of the Tower of Labab. It is generally acknowledged that it is good at healing disease. The Fire Thistle. This strange plant only grows on a number of grass-colored hills at the northern end of Mira's Island. It has been known to heal blindness. Okay. And then Wingate Book. Report on the Wingates of Lyramion by Thalion the Scholar. 1. What are Wingates? Wingates were conceived by a gifted magician and inventor many hundreds of years ago. They served, and still serve today, to quickly bridge great distances on Lyramion. Today there are still 12, or more correctly, 24 Wingates on Lyramion. A gate cannot operate by itself. Each time one wishes to use one of the gates, there must be another gate active at the intended destination. What does one need to use them? Wind pearls, right? Transportation through the wind gates is only possible if you have a so-called wind chain in use. Oh. Today there are very few of these chains left, but it's possible to manufacture new chains. On the Island of Winds, there is the Wind Shrine. It has two altars. If you join together a chain of Mother of Pearl as well as 12 Wind Pearls, on the right altar, this will create a new Wind Chain. Sounds a lot more complicated than the Wind Gates in the first game. 3. What does one do if a gate is destroyed? The inventor of the gates also developed the ability to repair damaged gates easily. To do so, you need a rod made of rare Zenobel wood and a normal gem. The rod is used at the left altar in the Wind Shrine. It melts with the gem and then becomes a rod of construction. If this is moved close to a defective gate, it is repaired again. Well, that's exciting. Now we got two new books. Until all this time, we just had one, which is the Book of Arachnids, I believe it's called. Just checking around, making sure this on the other side we can't get some other book. I don't know which one it meant for me. Okay, I think that's just a stock message then. Although two books interested me. The Book of Paladins. Okay. They all interest me. The Last Paladin. Before the Great Flood, there were many. After the Flood, only one is still alive. His name is Griban. Oh, wow. Remember Griban? From Amherstar. His life is dedicated to light, and he was put to eternal sleep by the mighty magicians. Now he rests on a bed of marble at the Fortress of Godsbane and awaits the day when he is needed again to fight against the darkness. Wow. Alright, so. Seems like we're going to be going back to the Fortress of Godsbane at some point. Hopefully we don't have to, like, get the exact spot. I'm gonna assume not and hope that's the case. So, through here. Is this the one we came through? It is, but there's another one across. Wait. You're here! Alright, so. Let's try this door now. More books! Oh my god. Amongst the books, you find a large number of magic spell scrolls.